What's going on, everyone? Austin John Plays here, and today I'm going to be going over how you could get yourself your special gift Cosmog, as well as Poipole, in Pokemon Sword and Shield's Crown Tundra. These are two gift Pokemon that you're going to be able to get in the game. They are shiny locked, telling you right up front, no reason in soft resetting. There's a very good chance that you found yourself Cosmog, and whether you remember to go get it or not, or if you saw my other video on how to get it, very simply, after obtaining your ice pony or ghost pony who attacked the village, before heading up to the final battle to catch Calyrex, you could just head inside of this woman's house right here, and you can see Cosmog just chilling over here. He says, "Kosh," and then we're going to speak to the woman. "Thank you for protecting the village from that awful bully of a Pokemon. I can trust that you take good care of my dear Foofy." "Yes. Yes, I would like to take care of your Foofy. Its name is Nebby, okay? It's not Foofy, it's Nebby." And there we go. Cosmog has been added to the party. The Cosmog that you're going to be getting is going to be level 5. It has no moves or anything else. It's generally not seen as a very good Pokemon. And then at level 43, Cosmog is going to be evolving into Cosmoem, which it's going to remain in that form until level 53, which in Pokemon Sword, you can evolve Cosmoem into Solgaleo, and in Pokemon Shield, you can evolve Cosmoem into Lunala. Now, it's worth mentioning that you can get shiny Solgaleo and Lunala in the Dynamax Adventures. This Cosmog and therefore Cosmoem are shiny locked. They will never be shiny. In fact, they are some of the, I think, 20 Pokemon forms that are completely shiny locked, like Keldeo, that you cannot get shiny whatsoever. Now, on to Poipole and Naganadel. In the Dynamax Adventures, you have to complete missions 1, 2, and 3 to unlock Legendary Quest question mark. And Legendary Quest question mark, this boy right here, is ordered to get yourself the Ultra Beasts. And to complete it, you have to catch yourself Necrozma. Necrozma is gonna appear randomly in the Dynamax Adventures. He is pure psychic type, so he will only appear when the end of it says Necrozma. Boom, there's Necrozma. And my shiny Articuno, I'm proud of that one. And then you start encountering Ultra Beasts, like this Cartano over here. And there's been some conflicting reports on how exactly to get Poipole to show up. I've seen some people say that you need to encounter 5 Ultra Beasts. Some people said that you need to do 15 Dynamax Adventures. But one thing has remained consistent between everyone, and I'm still constantly testing this out here, is that after you catch Necrozma. So you have to catch Necrozma and then go talk to Peony over here. And then he's going to mark your legendary clue complete. He's going to say, "So this one's Necrozma, the prison Pokemon. It looks dark and prisoned me." Cool. And then you're going to get some free stuff. I cover that in the Ultra Beast video. And also, after doing every round, you should go talk to Peony's daughter over here, who lets you know, "Oh, I found Tapu Koko. Sweet." And then also, if you talk to her again, you might get more eyepieces. Boom! Yellow futuristic shades. Nice. So I'm actually actively testing whether it's going to be 15 Dynamax Adventures after reporting Necrozma complete, or if it's 5 Ultra Beasts after reporting Necrozma complete, or if it's catching 5 Ultra Beasts after reporting Necrozma complete. I'm pretty sure that I've found 5 Ultra Beasts already, but you know what? I'm just now going to head back in there, do some more Dynamax Adventures, and let you know 100% which of these factors it is. So first I'm going to get my numbers up to 15 Dynamax Adventures, and then I'm going to encounter 5 different Ultra Beast species, and then I'm going to catch 5 different Ultra Beast species to see which of these requirements it actually is. If I do come across an Ultra Beast before I find myself the legendaries, then I'm going to just exit out. So I'll let you know when I'm done with this testing here. Luxury ball, of course. Was that my 15th one? And nope, no, still no. Okay. Hey there, guys, it's me checking in. 5 hours later. So did some extensive testing here, and I can confirm 100% that the rumor going around that in order to get Poipole you have to complete 15 Dynamax Adventures is false, or at least not completely true. So I finally found Guzzlord, and we lost the first time around, so now I'm going after Guzzlord again. And now I'm starting to believe that we have to catch the Ultra Beasts. In addition to Necrozma, I think I need to catch 4 or 5 additional Ultra Beasts.
5 Ultra Beasts in total. Nope, none of them are shiny. This is the best way to check if they're shiny, because the shiny icon will show up to the left of the Galar icon. Yep, we're taking Guzzlor home, which is a shame, because I really wanted to shiny hunt that. Now, if you ever need to keep track of who you did catch, you could just walk over here, and Peony will actually show you a list of all the Pokemon that you've caught. So far I have Necrozma, and Guzzlord, and Kartana. So, in theory, I just need 2 more Ultra Beasts, and then it might work. And fantastic, Zerkatree over here is going to be my 5th Ultra Beast. And it's now 3 p.m. when I originally planned on putting this video out. Nice. So supposedly, now that I have Zerkatree, that's going to be the last one that I need, not shiny, the last one that I need in order for this Poipole to show up. I just chose no. Well, poop in a hat. I'm so used to saying no that I... Okay. Which, I've learned that if you play offline with animations off, this is like 8 minutes instead of 20. Like, it's so much faster. I told the game I was doing a Zerkatree run, and this is what it gives me. All water types. Great. Thanks, game. Great. Took it down with 2 water types on the team. Which is kind of ridiculous. All right, Luxury Ball. And of course, I always have to show this screen for the chance of a possible shiny reaction. Nope, no shiny. That's what I thought. Okay, stop. No, no. I do want to take the Zerkatree. There it is. Almost did it twice. And that's my 5th Ultra Beast. And... no? Where is he? Does Necrozma not count as a Ultra Beast? He might not count as an Ultra Beast. Do you have anything special for me? You found a Celesteela down there. Perfect. That's exactly what I need. I'll buy it. And fantastic. That is Celesteela down. Had to do it twice because he has Earthquake, and that one shot everyone last time, and that was not fun. Let's take a look, see what we got. Quagsire, Sandscorch, Durant, and Celesteela. We are taking the Celesteela home. This is now my 5th Ultra Beast in addition to Necrozma. And... yes! You saw it pop in? You saw it pop in? It popped in. That's it. That's exactly it. You need to catch 5 Ultra Beasts, not including Necrozma. So, you have to go through, you have to do missions 1, 2, and 3, and then you have to do adventure number 4. After adventure number 4 is complete and you catch Necrozma, or probably throughout mission number 4. Maybe you don't need to catch Necrozma yet. But you need to catch 5 of the Ultra Beasts between Nihiligo, Buzzswole, Pheromosa, Zerkatree, Celesteela, Kartana, Guzzlord, Stakataka, and Blastphalon. Then, and only then, does this little guy show up. It's not... repeat, it is not, you have to do 15 Dynamax Adventures. Any website and any YouTuber who says that is incorrect. No, you have to catch 5 Ultra Beasts. That is the requirement. Then, come over here, talk to Poipole. I believe this Pokemon is known as Poipole. I found it a little while ago within the Max Lair, but the more I study it, the more questions I have. It's such a strange Pokemon. I believe it has something to do with the current situation we're in. I really need to buckle down and focus my research on the Max Lair, but Poipole keeps trying to wander off as soon as I take my eyes off of it. I'd like a skilled trainer to accept Poipole and take care of it for me. You wouldn't happen to be interested, would you? Sure would. Great. He's so happy. Look at that. Look at that smiley face. Just so you know, this Poipole is shiny locked. It cannot be shiny. There is no point in soft resetting for it to be shiny or anything else. Look at this. Look at this little cute boy right here. There we go. There's our Poipole. He's so sweet. It looks like Guzzlord and Kartana were playing, or Kartana is now bouncing off. For those unfamiliar with Poipole, it requires to know a certain move before it evolves. You can just head to any Pokemon Center and go to the Move Relearner over here, and that move is going to be Dragon Pulse. Then all you need to do is level him up one time. Rare Candy, Poipole, boom. 21. And now we get to evolve our adorable little Poipole into my main man, the homie, the super scary, the Mega Wasp from the outer space, Naganadel. Look at that. Look at the Naganadel over here. I don't know why I say it so New Jersey Italian-y. And just like that, that's how to get Poipole, Naganadel, Cosmog, and Cosmoem. Over here. Over here, buddy. All of you over here. All of yous. Nebby. There you go. Cosmoem. Hey. Wow, okay, he can move fast. Yeah, everyone over here. Everyone over here. Yeah. Look at these boys. Cosmoem, Cosmog, Poipole, Naganadel's in the background. Great. That, you know what? These boys look so adorable right here. I think that's gonna be the thumbnail. I don't know why he's doing that. Could we get Naganadel over here too? Naganadel. Hey, Nebby. Nebby ran off. He got scared. Hey. This thing is freaking scary in the face. It is a wasp though. We're wasps, not monsters, alright? Well, there you go, guys. That is how you're gonna be getting yourself Cosmog, Cosmoem, Poipole, and Naganadel in Pokemon Sword and Shield's Crown Tundra. If you found this helpful, do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button down below. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe, turn on notifications. Until next time, Austin John out.